Hello and welcome along to this tutorial on getting started with Camunda. My name is Niall Deehan. I'm an international consultant with Camunda, and there in the picture with me is Butch Deadlift, a fun little hawk. So today we're going to start talking about some simple steps in which you can go from nothing to having Camunda up and running. We're going to get the platform, we're going to get the modeler, going to install Java if you haven't already done that, and we're going to create a model and actually deploy it to the platform. So the parts of Camunda that we'll actually be dealing with today are, of course, the platform itself. When we download the platform, it's going to contain, of course, the engine itself, which is this box right here. It's going to contain a simple H2 database that's going to run with it. It's also going to have some front-end applications, specifically task lists, which is intended for end users and people who want to start processes and complete tasks, as well as Cockpit, which is where admins can go to actually maintain processes, do things like migration, manipulate the processes in runtime. We're also going to have the modeler itself, which is a different application. This is a JavaScript application to help you build BPMN 2.0 models. And the idea here is we're going to download both of these. We're going to build a model in the modeler, deploy it to the engine, start it with a task list, and then manipulate it and see it running in Cockpit. Okay, so that's that described. So let's get started. Okay, so as that list I showed you suggests, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go and download the Camunda platform. So to start with that, I'm going to go to docs.camunda.org/enterprise. Okay, that should bring us to the enterprise page, and I'm going to click on the download button right here. You can see that the enterprise download button has a bunch of versions here on the left. We also have the patch releases here, and then finally we have the distributions. I'm going to go with WildFly 10. If you're not using the enterprise version, you can go to camunda.org and download the open source version. I'm going to click on the zip here because I want to get the full platform along with the server and everything else. If I wanted just the WAR files, I could click here. Okay, and once that is downloaded, we should be brought to this guy right here. I've downloaded this in my downloads folder, so you can see this is the zip file I just downloaded, and now I just need to extract this to run it. While that's extracting, I'm going to minimize that, and I'm going to show you briefly how, if you don't already have Java, that you're going to need to get that. So what you need to do is just go to Java JDK download. That should bring you to Oracle's site for downloading the JDK. We can see that we have a download button right here, so follow that. Once you agree to the license, then pick whichever distribution is associated with the platform you're running. I happen to be using Windows 64-bit, so I can download this guy right here. Okay, and once you download and install that, you should be able to then get the container up and running. The main reason we're using this is because we want to actually run WildFly. WildFly requires Java 8, so I'm going to, that's why I'm downloading this. There are different requirements depending on how you run the engine, but as we're using a container for this, we're going to need Java to run. So meanwhile, I should have, this guy here has been extracted, and I can double click in here to see what all of the fuss is about. So we see here that we have a server. That's where WildFly is right now. We have a license, a README, and all the rest of it. The important thing here is the start Camunda.bat. So if I double click on that, it'll start up the server and it will start running. This is the point where if you don't have Java installed, you'll probably see, you won't see the startup in the same way. Okay, so we should be brought to this welcome page. And this page shows that we have cockpit, task list, admin, and a simple welcome page. I'll be spending some time showing you guys around these two applications. What we're looking at here is actually an AngularJS application that communicates to the engine via REST. So anything you see me do in cockpit or task list, we can do via the REST API. Okay. this said, we will kick things off with taking a look at Cockpit. If I select this, I should then be brought here, and the login is demo, password demo, and then click sign in. And then we should be seeing this page here. So initially you'll see that we have 6 running process instances. These are part of the demo process that's deployed along with the when you actually download the platform. We also have 6 human tasks running, and we also have a license key to be entered. So I'm going to select this and just add the license key so I can unlock the rest of the bits and pieces in Camunda. With our license key added, we can now return back to Cockpit and take a look at some of the enterprise features. To do that, you can go to the top right with this nice little house up there. And if you select that, you can select Cockpit. And this will bring us back to the same page, but we should have a little more visuals here because we've added the license key. Next, I'm going to go to the process definition and take a look that right here we have one process that's deployed and 6 running instances. So if I select this invoice receipt process, we should then see that we have 3 instances running. We have 1 instance at prepare bank transfer, 1 instance at approve invoice, and 1 instance here at review invoice. So the first thing I want to do is show how to view a history of our process. So if I select, for instance, this task here, I should see that it's rounded down that to one single instance, and I can select that. And now I can view some bits and pieces about the currently running instance, as the variables and the user tasks that it's currently at. We see here there's no current assignee. And but we can also decide to view the history of this particular process by clicking on the history tab at the top here. What this will show us is the route the process has taken. So we see that we started here. We have an audit log that we can follow. We ran this decision table. We then went to approve this process. It then arrived at this gateway, and then shortly after it arrived here. At each point, we can see the history of what that task did. So for instance, this is a business rules task. So if I select this and select executed decision instances, I should see that it has actually run a couple of DMN tables. And if I select one of these, I can then see the specific instance of the table that was run. We can see here that using some process variables like invoice amount 900 with category MISC, this rule matched and we returned a classification of budget. Okay, there's some other things you can do that are kind of useful here. If I return back to the runtime view, I can maybe do some manipulation in here. Like, for instance, I can decide maybe to change some variables. Maybe I'll change amount to something else, like 9,000 instead of 900. I can also manipulate the process state. So, for instance, if I would quite like this process to actually return back to, let's say, approve invoice, I can select the modify tab. And now I have the ability to drag and drop tokens in other parts of the process. So if I drop this here, we should see that we are saying that please start a new token before the approve invoice, but also cancel the token currently at prepare transfer. So if I click apply modification, I'll get the you are playing with fire message. In case you're wondering, if you're about to do something cool and interesting, you will see the you are playing with fire message. Once I click proceed, the state then transitions and changes, and now we are at this point in the process instead. The variables are not affected by this. Okay, another fun thing we can do is right now, the invoice receipt process, those who are eagle-eyed would have noticed that while I have 3 instances here, back when I click on processes, the process tab showed that I had 6 running instances. So where are these 3 hidden guys? Well, if I click into invoice receipt, we may notice this little guy here. The top left here, it has the version. And I have version 1 right here. And this has another 3 instances running. This is slightly different because it has a notified creditor task. So one of the nice things about Camunda is that we can run multiple instances at the same time. multiple versions of the same instance at the same time, that is. And once these processes are running, they're very happy to continue on their own version unless you decide against it. For instance, right now, let's say I want to migrate these lovely processes to my new version, to version 2. I can do this by clicking on this incredibly subtle symbol here on the bottom. This little arrow says migrate processes to latest version. So if I select that, I should then see that version 1, which is the version I'm in, and version 2, which is the newest version, are side by side. And if I click on show migration map, I can see that the engine has sort of pre-planned the mapping. So it's saying that, for instance, instances from bank transfer are going to go to bank transfer, and instances from invoice processing, or sorry, approve invoice, are also going to go to approve invoice. Okay, next up, I'm going to, I can, if I want, maybe decide I don't want that, so I can decide maybe instead of moving these guys to approve invoice, I can instead say, in fact, you know what, move approve invoice to here, let's say. Okay, so let's move next into selecting an instance. I can select a specific version if I like, or specific instance using these filters. So by variable or by business key or by the specific activity they're currently in. I'm just going to select everything and then continue. So next we have the final page where we confirm what we're doing. Once again, we're about to do something cool. So I'm going to click execute migration. Okay, so that is running now in the background, and the migration should be complete pretty quick. If we select, we should of course still have 6 instances running on our invoice receipt. And once we have this guy here, we can see that we now have all instances are all part of the same process. We have 2 here, 2 here, and 2 here. Okay. And with the tour of Cockpit complete, we can now get on the work of actually building our own process and deploying it to Camunda. So to do that, I'm going to start by opening a new tab and typing in camunda.org/download/modeler. Okay. And here we'll be brought to a page that has the various distributions of the modeler, depending on what operating system you're using. Download either the Mac or the Windows version. So I'm going to use the Windows version because I'm using Windows. Once that is downloaded, good stuff, it should bring me to my downloads folder where I have everything else downloaded. And here I can right click and unzip this modeler. Okay, so that's complete now. And I can open up the directory there that's been unzipped and find the Camunda modeler executable. Double-clicking on that should bring us to open up the modeler itself. And we should see 3 lovely little buttons here. One for creating BPMN, one for DMN, and another one for CMN. For this, we'll just concentrate on BPMN. I'm not going to spend too much time on the modeler. I'll leave that for another video. But for here, I'm just going to create, we have our start event here. I'm going to create a task. I'm going to use the morph tool to change this to a user task, so I can see something visible when I log in. And then I'm going to say, give it a name, write something. And finally, I'm going to create an end event that will end the process. Okay, so next up, if you don't already see the properties panel here on the right, you can click on it to open it. And this is where we actually give all the execution semantics required to make this run. So in this case, I just need to give this a ID and a name. And now I can save this to my desktop. I'll call it demo. Okay, so right now we have an XML file that's BPMN 2.0. And the fun part now is just simply deploying it to Camunda. So I'm going to go back to my web browser, go back to Cockpit. And Cockpit has a bunch of tabs up here. The one you want to go to here is More, and then click on Deployments. Okay, well, here you'll see a lovely little deploy button here. And again, we're playing with fire, so fun stuff ahead. And we can click up here on the choose files button to select the file we just created, open it, give this a name, and then click deploy. Okay, so it says that here that's been deployed successfully. And if we actually go to processes, we should then be able to see that among our invoice processes is also demo process. Okay. And to start this process and actually visualize what's happening, we go back to the little house in the top right, go to task list, and here is where the UI for end users, people who want to complete tasks and start processes are. We have here some filters on the left that filter the tasks here. So if I select this, for instance, you can see these are tasks associated to demo. If I select accounting, these are all tasks that are part of the accounting group. For our purposes, I'm going to select all tasks. I'm going to go up to the top right up here. Here you'll see the start process button. I'm going to click that and then click demo, which is our process. You can give it a business key if you like, or you can just click start. Okay, what that should show us is that our task now should appear on this list. If I select it, you can see that there's a placeholder UI for it, as well as the current location of this task. From a cockpit perspective, if I go back here, I can refresh this page to see a token indicating the point in which this process is. Okay, so hopefully that's enough to get you going on the initial steps towards using Camunda. In the meantime, you can keep up with things that Camunda is doing by some of these links. The blog is going to have some really nice posts on what sort of new things Camunda is doing, as well as when we do things like sort of experiment with new technologies and things, we tend to blog about them as well. You can follow us on Twitter, and of course the forum is available for questions that you might have. There's also the network.camunda.org, where you can check out what meetings Camunda is hosting, webinars that we have coming up, and of course white papers. Great, thanks a lot. See you again. Bye bye.